Welcome friends in standard 9. We are going to start with science. My name is Aziz sir and I will be teaching you science. We are going to start with chapter 1st, matter in our surrounding. Right? Now first of all we need to understand what is a word as in matter. Now what is a word as a matter? We actually as a humans understand two things. What is word as a matter and second thing is energy. So we understand and measure the things that is matter, and sometimes we don't understand the things or are not measurable for us in very fine called as an energy. Now matter, generally as in definition, matter means nothing but occupying space and have mass, right? So the things which have something is there, some of the atoms, molecules, whatever is present. So it is occupying some space there, that is called as, that means it is having mass and volume basically. So it has a mass, and occupies some volume. If it is there something, then we call it is matter is present. If nothing is there, then it is a vacuum. So we can't call that as a matter. Now according to Indian philosophers, we say we are made up of panch tattva, that is five things. So these five things are nothing but air, earth, fire, sky and water. So these are the five things that we understand generally. Air is unseen thing, but the molecules of air we understand that, like oxygen, nitrogen, argon, xenon, krypton, many of them are there, right? Even water molecules, carbon dioxide counts in air. And we feel it also when the fan is on, that means the particles are present. We understand earth on which that we are living on, fire that is produced in the form of an energy, we understand heat in our body as in fire, sky is nothing but again that I would say it is a vacuum portion or a space that is nothing is present there, that is in sky, and water. So we are made up of such five things that we understand. Right, so we had been from our Indian culture, we had been understanding such kind of things from very back up. Now we are going to, in this particular chapter, trying to understand deeply in scientific concept what is basically matter means. So matter in terms of scientific concept, we are going to learn the next topic as physical nature of matter. Now physical nature of matter, we learn in terms of points, okay, what is the physical nature of matter. First of all, we need to understand that matter is made up of some particles. Particles, in general we speak out, but it is form of an atoms and molecules. So it contains particles, that is a basic, I would say, that minimum thing that it contains is particles, smallest thing. So it is made up of continuous thing, that means the whole substance, if I count as one substance like sodium chloride, that is salt, namak, that is made up of all the particles of NaCl only. So this particular substance is made up of a continuous frame of one particular substance. Now as we also know that, as I told you, that the size of the particles are very small. If the size of the particles are very small, that means it is unimaginable for us that it turns to 10 is to minus 15 of its radius size, which is very 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 small. It is almost obviously unseen for us. That means we ourselves are also matter, and we are made up of atoms and molecules, millions and millions of them. So three things, as I told you, it is made up of particles, it is made up of continuously one types of particles, that means a lattice, I would say, in terms of chemistry, that means it contains the same type of particles, and thirdly the size of the particles is very small. Right, to understand this we need to understand one activity, that is, I would show you one activity that is about potassium permanganate. Now in terms of potassium permanganate, we are seeing that we are taking 6 glasses of that is 6 beakers we are taking basically, and we are starting to put potassium permanganate inside the first beaker. As you are able to see that I am showing you that a potassium permanganate is put inside the first beaker and stirred up by the spoon, and the color of the beaker turns very dark violet, right? And this violet, so what we need to learn from this about the particles, that is, you are able to see that the injection is brought and the 40 ml is been picked out from it and put to the second beaker. Now, as you are seeing that it is put to the second beaker, you are able to see that the color is fainting. The particular color of beaker is getting fainted. Fainted means it is getting dilute. Now, as it is getting dilute, and I am, you are able to see in this experiment, they are going on taking out from each beaker and continuously they are passing from one beaker, they are taking up the 40 ml solution and passing to the second beaker. Now, doing so, we are able to understand the particular nature, that is, matter is made up of particles basically. That means KMnO4 is made up of particles, and the size of the particles are very small. How does we know, how do we know that as we are going on passing from one beaker to the another beaker, you are able to see that the concentration of the particles from one beaker, it is getting to the lower every time, and you are able to see the less number of particles present, and it makes us assure that these particles are present, and as their concentration changes and the space between the particles also increases, that shows the fainting in color, right? The color of the particles is fainting. So this is the first thing that we are able to understand from passing from each beaker to the another beaker. And obviously one more thing that we are not able to see still the particles, that means the size of the particles are very well. As seeing this experiment of potassium permanganate, the same time if you are not having a potassium permanganate, you can perform this same experiment. If you are having a Dettol in your house, you may take some Dettol which is quite concentrated, put into a take 5-6 cups, maybe 3, you can take it 3 cups you may take it. From the first cup that you have put some drops of Dettol inside, it will be very dark. If you are going to take out with a small injection, unused injection, and put it inside the another, make it a small amount like 10 ml or something, and if you are going on putting with the next to next glass, you are going to find taking the same amount of water, you are able to see that it has turned dilute. The same experiment can be performed at home also, right? Now, what is characteristics of the particles? That is the next topic we are going to see, that what are the characteristics of the particles of the matter. Now, first characteristics of the particle, basically we are going to learn 3 as in characteristics of the particle. First, the characteristics of the particle is that the matter is having a space between them. A space is always there, that means whatever the frame of the particles are there, there is always some space between them, whether they are in the solid, whether they are in the liquid, or whether in the gaseous state. Gaseous state, we are in the gaseous atmosphere, so we are already in the creating some space between the gaseous molecules. That can be a one example. Now today I am going to show you one experiment to prove it, that the particle between the particles, the space is there. Now, as you are able to see here in this particular experiment, that we are taking a beaker. In this particular beaker, we are taking an 100 ml, exactly 100 ml, that has been marked and that has been shown to you, that a 100 ml beaker is present. In this 100 ml beaker, you are able to see evaporating dish, you are able to see a salt which has been kept there, and this particular salt is taken and put inside the beaker and it is stirred, right? So you are able to see that the salt is getting dissolved inside the water. This is a simple experiment which can be performed at home also. You can take a glass, mark there in the blue form with your ball pen, and put some salt inside. After putting the salt inside, you still are able to see on the beaker that the mark is 100 only. That means you have put a 2-3 spoon salt, so that has got dissolved. Now, dissolved word means the simple thing, that the salt has got accumulated inside the space between the water molecules. It has not created another volume and has risen the like 100 to 110 ml or something around. It has remained 100 only, and the salt has been filled inside the space between the water molecules. So this is a proof. We can say that the particles have space between them, and this salt has occupied the space between the water molecules. The second we are going to take is the topic of matter is continuously moving. Now, the matters are continuously moving, but one more thing, that it gets affected by the temperature. If the temperature is risen, the continuous moving is basically known as a Brownian motion. In chemistry terms, it is known as a Brownian motion. Now, Brownian motion, we see the particles are continuously moving. But with the rise in temperature, this movement of the particles is rising. Now, movement of the particles are nothing but kinetic energy of the molecules. So, with a given heat, there is a rise in temperature and the motion, that is kinetic energy of the molecules, increases. Seeing one this experiment, we are seeing, again taking a two glass of water, we are able to see that one glass of the water is having a common water with the same mark, and the second is having the same amount of water with slightly higher temperature. That means we can say it is hot. Now, same amount of potassium permanganate is taken and put in the first cold glass, which is having a cold water. You are able to see the diffusion process happening. And in the second one, once the potassium permanganate is put in the hot water, you are able to see that it is getting diffused. That means these particles are traveling very faster. That means they are moving very fast. Why it is happening so? Because the kinetic energy is very fast. Those two things we are proving. The first thing, that the particles are always in motion. Secondly, with the rise in temperature, the kinetic energy of the molecules rises. Fine. The third is, the particle of matter attract each other. So we are going to see with one experiment of water. You can perform this experiment at home also. It's not a big deal. You can take a coin. As you are able to see here, inside this experiment, that the matter attracts each other. Now, matters attract each other, that means the common matter we are taking as water molecules. I am showing you in this experiment that the water molecules are attracting each other. You can take a drop of water by, if you are having a straw, you can put a straw inside the another water glass and put it this one drop wise and allow it to drop on the coin, a 10 rupee coin, and you are able to see the drop is falling. It is forming a sphere. That means the molecules are not allowing to move. If it is going to allow to move, these particles would spread out, right? But it is not. That means they are attracting each other. And you are going on putting water molecule droplets on it, as you are seeing in this experiment. And you are able to see continuously that these particles are attracting each other and making a bulb, but not allowing these particles to go away. That means these water molecules are attracting each other. That means generally matter attracts each other. Otherwise, this earth would have got spread out. So, these particles attract each other continuously, like water we are seeing, that water molecule. Now, if the river is also flowing, you put a finger inside it, you are able to see the water is dripping out besides your finger and it is running out. That means they are pulling other particles and taking it away with them. So, in this experiment, it confirms that particles of matter attract each other. Fine. So we will keep up till here, as this particular is a big question that with terms of exam point of view, characteristics of particles of matter. So we'll keep up till here for this lecture. Thank you.